So we are at Bell Ridge Wildlife and Environmental Area, and we are capturing primarily Florida mice. We have been looking at this property for almost 2 years now, pre and post burn. It's on a 2-year burn rotation, and the purpose of capturing the mice is looking at population and movement response pre and post burn. We check to see whether it's a Florida mouse. Out here you might also have old field mice, and we have cotton rats occasionally, and we also have harvest mice. So we identify it first. We tag everything with unique ear tags so that we can tell when we capture it again. We look for gender and whether or not it's reproductively active. We get the age on the animal.
Was that a female?
Actually, it is a female. We are trapping at gopher tortoise burrows, which is a little different than some small mammal trapping where you would just trap straight grids or transect lines. So we're trapping at gopher tortoise burrows, and we make sure that there are no fire ants that are there. If we find fire ants, we move the traps away from that particular gopher tortoise burrow, and when we take them out of the field during the day, we put them up in a tree so that the fire ants don't get to them. We also never bait with anything but seed. Sometimes people want to bait small mammal traps with things like raisins, fruit, peanut butter. We never use that in Florida because of the fire ant danger. The fire ants are pervasive enough that they can kill the mouse, and if we have a mouse mortality related to fire ants, we pull the traps and we do not trap that station anymore. So here's your trap, and we would put seeds in and bedding because it's cool for the mouse. So we put the seeds and the bedding in, and then we have to make sure that the trap closes fairly easily. So the mouse is going to run in here, and there's a plate at the back that when the mouse steps on it causes the door to close. Try to keep it flat on the front because the mice don't necessarily like to go up over a seal. And this is actually, we put cover over it to make sure it stays shaded in case the sun comes out. We don't want it to get hot on any of the individual boxes, so it keeps it a little shaded. The burrow is where the Florida mouse lives. They are not able to burrow from the surface particularly well, so they go inside of another animal's burrow to burrow. And so gopher tortoises are the primary species that they are commensal with. They will use an armadillo burrow or some other hole. Florida mice make chimneys. So sometimes instead of going in the opening of the gopher tortoise hole, they'll actually move away and there'll be a little hole, not with a fan or anything. It's very nondescript, so just a little hole, and they'll go down that, and it's an escape chimney so that if a snake or something comes in, they can go out.
Okay.
So she's reproductive.
Okay, little
yeah,
girly
she
girl.
Is.
You're almost done with your little girly girl. She is 35 and a half.
If our management is such that they don't have the seeds they need, they don't have the ground cover they need, even though they don't technically qualify for listing anymore, there's the concern that we would need to relist in the future because of the management or the lack of management of good sandhill habitat.